But if someone were to have their lipid panel done by their physician and it was 150, let's say they didn't know their APOE4, their physician would look at that and go, "Whoa, that's really high."
Right. And I think if there's, it depends not just on the LDL, but there's a range. If you want to actually pick a number, the sort of consensus number that the lipid community, the cardiology community, has accepted as mandating attention for genetic reasons is an LDL actually of 190. So it's even higher than that. So I'll start with that. If your LDL is 190 and greater, the particle measurement probably isn't going to affect the treatment decision because in almost all cases, those patients have genetic abnormalities. APOE may be part of it, but not the cause of those very high levels. That's usually an LDL receptor abnormality. Those patients are at sufficiently high lifelong risk of heart disease that they are candidates for statin therapy almost in all cases. It's very difficult to achieve a significant approach towards optimizing LDL levels in those patients. So that's 190. 150, sort of halfway in between. So that's a gray zone. And so it depends not just on the LDL, but the overall risk. Blood pressure, diabetes, family history.
Triglycerides.
Triglycerides have not entered into the equation. There's epidemiologists that do all this number crunching and they come up with risk assessment tools. Triglyceride hasn't entered into it because it's so tightly related to everything else. And it's a very bouncy measurement. It's much less stable over time, even from day to day, as LDL cholesterol and HDL cholesterol. So it sort of falls out of these equations. But it's part of this atherogenic dyslipidemia phenotype. It's part of that trait. It's important, but as a measurement, it doesn't stand up to the LDL particles in terms of its association with risk or even HDL. So anyway, this risk assessment is done, and then you decide, well, is this patient at sufficiently high risk using these, if you're in the swing of things with the guidelines, you do these assessments of the likelihood of having a heart attack over the next 10 years. And if it's high enough, then you jump in with aggressive treatment. And I think if the risk is high enough, you probably use statins. You use statins for those patients as well. But it's not an automatic decision. That's where the particle measurement hasn't yet achieved the level of acceptance to enter into these risk calculation formulas, partly because the risk assessment tools that we have work pretty well by themselves. This is actually a very interesting point from a sort of a, should I say, a conceptual standpoint. So I'm just going to say this because it's maybe a little bit complicated. But when you have some very strong predictors of heart disease risk, blood pressure, diabetes, even LDL cholesterol, HDL cholesterol, these standard measurements, and you throw them into a risk formula and you add in age and sex, you can explain a lot of risk that way. You can argue what that explanatory number is, whether it's 50% or 70%, it's very high. So if you add LDL particles or these more refined measurements of particle concentrations into those formulas, you don't get much additional explanation of risk because a lot of these things are interrelated with one another. And so there is a confusion between the magnitude by which you can improve risk prediction by these measurements versus what's really important biologically that you should be treating. So people think, well, because the particle measurements don't add that much to the risk assessment, but it adds a measurable amount. It's just not a lot. People say, well, let's not worry about that. But from a biological standpoint, that may be the driving factor. So if you turn that whole process around and you throw out the standard factors and you just use the particle concentrations and maybe a few other things like age and sex, you can also explain a lot of the risk. So you can choose your weapon, but you don't confuse the ability to predict risk with what you should be treating because those are not always the same. I hope that's not too complicated. But that to me is a very interesting point.
It is very interesting. It is very interesting. It is a little complicated.
It is complicated, so you may not want to get too far into that.